He's checking the. There he goes. Got the full power ready for his takeoff. Something you might notice about this aircraft compared to one of these: four bladed propeller instead of three, which will make it slightly quieter. Swoop on. Very light aeroplane, lots of power, straight up into a half loop. Steve, when I spoke to him this morning, I said, you want me quadrant to talk about? I said, well, this is a one-off. So I'm not going to display this aeroplane except here at Sywell. So you're getting a very unique treat, it sounds like. Nice, slow roll to inverted and a push out. Still pushing at outside half loop. Rolling on the way down the 45. I asked if the aircraft had a name, and his wife calls it Tigger, for fairly obvious reasons. It's going to start rolling to 90 degrees, 180. Hesitation rolls in the vertical, stopping purely vertical into a stall turn over the top. Twist on the way down the hill. I asked him about the significance to the colour scheme of this aircraft, and Steve said, well, the factory colour scheme from Game Composites was very boring. So he started coming up with some ideas, he just got crazier and crazier, and this is what he ended up with. See how tight Steve's keeping this display. Into the vertical once more, now rolling left. This is called a torque roll. Now that engine, producing a lot of power, that four-bladed propeller, when he gets to the top, obviously there's no authority in the ailerons, but the aircraft keeps rotating, just through to the reaction to the torque of that engine. Now into a flat spin. Rolling out back onto the display line. That torque roll, they are still rolling just because of that clear power in the aircraft and the torque in the engine. Pushing over the top of that vertical climb. The negative G at the top of it to zero G. Onto the 45, some rolls on the down line. Steve Jones before, he and Paul Bowen were the Red Bull Matadors in their Extreme Airs, their early variants if you like. This is a development of those aircraft, the Gamebird. Another slow roll, climbing over to left into inverted and a push. So this is a bit of a hybrid really, an aerobatic aircraft but also a tourer. I'm told the range of this aircraft is around 1300 miles when you've got fuel in the wing. So incredible aeroplane to take all around the world. And we're looking after some weekend baggage so you can go and have fun and also do some touring at the same time. Very light aeroplane developed by Admiral Philip Steinbach, who was in Lincolnshire to start with, and now he's moved over to the States where Game Composites has been established, and they are producing a large number, I could give you the figure, I'm afraid, but a large number of these aircraft every month. The order is full for these aircraft, as you can see there. Now, vertical manoeuvre, and very quickly, here's that torque roll I talked about. It's still rolling, but actually only by opposing the torque of the engine. And now tail slide, dropping back through the vertical through his own smoke. Similar to the extra, this aircraft stressed to plus 10, minus 10. In fact, I do believe it could have one where it was stressed to plus 12, minus 12, which is even. two-point roll as he climbs out, sorry, a three-point roll as he climbs out to our left. You can just see how much performance this aircraft has got. It's still climbing, even at a relatively low speed there. Talk about the control surfaces, the aileron, rudder and elevator. Oh, that's tumble there, that's to our right. The elevator, rudder and elevator, within the prop disc. In fact, the ailerons on a Gamebird are far bigger than those of an Astra, so you can do a roller coaster. The eagle-eyed among you may see both in Melanie's Extra and on this Gamebird that there's a almost coat hanger-esque protrusion on each wingtip. That is an aerobatic sight, so if you could see it as it goes past, it has a vertical line, and that's for the pilot. You see, I had a pilot's head, and it's him or her to use as they fly aerobatics to have reference to the horizon. It's almost like a protractor, if you like. The pilot looks at that protractor and puts the aircraft exactly at the angle they want to perform. And a pushover. To display this aircraft anywhere else except here at Sywell. He still flies the Warbirds here at Sywell. That was a push out to the 45, so a negative G push rolling down the hill. I did ask what Steve's routine would be. He said he couldn't actually tell me. He was just going to go and see what he could do, what energy he had, and then perform the manoeuvre he felt best for you watching from the ground. So that's exactly what he's done. So I think we might get a little topside pass now with a knife edge. So do get your cameras ready. And let's give Steve... Sorry for those who got their cameras ready. Rock and rolling as he climbs up to our right. He's having a lot of fun. Very envious. We can hear your appreciation, so please put your hands together and a huge round of applause for Steve Jones in his Gamebird GB1. So that is probably the end of the very dynamic flying we're going to get today here at the Sywell Air Show. But next